whatever the skills are that they see as being the top. So that's fix one. Fix two, they call appreciate the differences. And I would call it fix them in. And it's basically looking at, there may be differences between men and women, but the differences, there may be advantages to the differences that women bring to organizations. So some of you may be familiar with it. There's just been a lot of publicity in the States about a big study that Google has done on what makes efficient teams or effective teams that are creative and productive, et cetera. And it turns out that it's not a hero leader that makes them effective. It's somebody who can facilitate interaction by all the members of the team that enable the resources of all members to get used. Now, that's not the rugged individualist who mounts the barricades and wins the war all by himself. So it may well be that some of the skills that are more widely distributed among women in the population, like facilitation skills, are way undervalued in a lot of organizations. And fixing them in involves helping them understand what the skills really needed are for success. The third frame has to do with leveling the playing field. Which might be described as fix the structure or the policy. Because a lot of organizations have policies that, and structures that systematically disadvantage some people. So for example, in the US, there's currently quite a lot of concern about equal pay for equal work. And we've been talking about that for a long time. But when I asked one of my colleagues who is in the diversity management business, whether the framework I'm talking about here was still valid, she said, you betcha. And she had been talking last week to a woman who'd been promoted to a senior executive position in an organization and found out a few months later that when her predecessor had been appointed to that position, he had been given a signing bonus that was 10 times the signing bonus she was given. And apparently upper management figured that this woman was married, so she didn't need the money. She was not married. So their database was, in essence, some sort of structures and policies are fundamentally oriented in ways that disadvantage women. And some of them are very blatant, very obvious. I was talking to somebody earlier about changing Title IX in the US, which is legislation that in essence, the part that I'm interested in said, if a high school is going to use US dollars to support sports for boys, they have to use the same amount of dollars to support sports for girls. That led to my sisters, who went to high school in the 50s and 60s, never did a sport in their entire career and didn't do it afterwards. My daughter, who went to school in the 80s, spent a lot of more time doing sports than doing some of the other things that she might have been doing, and is still going to pass on at the ripe old age of 44, so she clearly didn't get good sense with the sports. But the point is, I think she learned something about her capacities and her ability to do things that my sisters